part of a decision was it to leave school?
Well, Ernie, it's never an easy decision. Each person has different reasons why they want to leave, financial responsibility, just getting tired. In my case, the Hack a Shack was created. I was getting beat up too much, and I heard my main man, Dick Vitale, say if Shaq leaves, he'll be the number one pick. So I didn't want to go back, get hurt, and possibly drop.
Yeah, because you could have been number two if you stayed a year, I'll tell you. But, you know, this guy, Freak, because if you would have played in that era with Freak, I don't know, Shaq. This guy, you know, he left school early, but he is something unique, different. But I thought bringing his skills to the NBA was big because that helps refine your game a little bit. He's ready. This guy was ready, Shaq.
I have an announcement. You know why he plays so well?
Why?
I'm his father.
Dun, 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 dun.
Love you, son. Congratulations.
That's one of the warmest and fuzziest stories I've heard all season long.
Way to keep
long.
Up with him his whole life.
I've been working.
Let's go to Kevin Harlan. They're ready for the tip. I've been working.
Welcome, folks. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for the latest presentation of our NBA basketball. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony with Doris Burke on our sidelines. Last outing for Atlanta, unsuccessful. The loss to Washington at the Verizon Center. They had a chance there right up to the end. They only lost by three.
And the issues they had defensively, in part, I thought, was a huge factor. Really compounded, I think, because it was a road game for them.
Well, you know, they gave the crowd a bunch to cheer about. And when you do that, you put yourself in a really tough position trying to come away with a road win.
And so off the tip, it's Toronto. All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Setting the floor for the Raptors. Lowry and DeRozan are the guard tandem. Patterson is the four with Valanciunas in the middle. And it's Carroll in at the small forward. The drive by Worthy. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. It's on Jonas Valanciunas.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
The Hawks shooting their first free throws of the night. And both free throws good for Worthy. So it's Toronto now. This game coming after a loss against the Pistons.
And it wasn't just about the bad shooting. It was really more so about the bad offense. They just didn't execute well. The screens weren't there. The spacing was poor. And thusly, the defeat.
Well, you've laid out a couple of the details that lead to good offense or bad if you don't execute them. Shooting is just a byproduct of not screening well and not moving the ball or players well. They didn't execute anything on the offensive end.
Here's T. After the made shot from Jonas Valanciunas, Worthy can't hit. Lowry against T. Outside DeRozan. Pass to Valanciunas. Down to five on the shot clock. Takes a shot at the elbow. Jump shot is good.
Really well done there. Just confident and composed. Never in a hurry.
Worthy a screen on Lowry. Teague against Lowry. Millsap has the open look. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague.
there's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Patterson, that's good.
And you're going to take as many of those high percentage shots as you can get.
The feed to Horford. There's the dish to Millsap. Here's Worthy. And it's Worthy again missing. The Raptors have gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. Patterson with it. And it's Horford picking him up. Out of bounds, Atlanta takes possession.
Now a moment to see the numbers for Houdini. He had a strong showing last season. Last season, he averaged 18 points per, 4 rebounds and 3 assists. And he had to pay his dues that rookie campaign, earning his stripes. A lot of people think he could have a breakout year this season.
Well, his coaches, his teammates, they've been singing his praises, Greg. I mean, let's see if he can prove them right.
Now here's Worthy. 29 points for him last game against the Wizards in Washington.
And he also controlled the backcourt as well. I mean, he really did a terrific job.
That'll be a 5-second call.
Toronto ball.
Now at the break on the floor, you can see the teams that led the NBA in steals last year. The Raptors in second.
Boy, they had so many guys with quick feet and quick hands on that team. I mean, they put relentless pressure on the opponent. And as a result, they came up with an awful lot of steals. I mean, this team has been very impressive defensively.
Now here's Carroll. Valanciunas with a screen on Worthy. Carroll dishes to DeRozan. Here's the three. No luck. Good D by Hardaway. The Hawks trailing. Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Dwayne Casey.
We talked about the keys to this game, and he singled out Paul Millsap as a player they've simply got to be mindful of. Coach told me he's always been an energy guy, someone you have to locate and box out every possession. But he's developed his offensive game to the point where he's more than just a hustle guy. He's also a scoring threat now and a guy we can't leave open. They'll be watching him, Kevin.
And thanks for that story, Doris. Now, here's DeRozan. 20 points for him last game against Detroit. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. T kicks it over to Worthy. No luck. Now, Toronto takes it the other way. Carroll passes to Lowry. Worthy with the double team. Deflects the pass. Millsap with the steal. Here's Hardaway, and it's denied. They retain possession. And a dunk by Horford. Here's DeRozan. Dishes it to Lowry. DeRozan with it. Now Carroll. Back to DeRozan. 4 on the shot clock. Knocked loose. Here's Worthy. Another miss by Worthy.
Tell you what, boy, it's hard to watch when the guy gets good shots and misses them. He's missed everything this quarter.
Carroll, no one around him. And again, Toronto, no luck. The Hawks leading. Right wing. Teague with the ball. Lowry picks him up. The kick out to Teague. Good on the three-point shot. Teague's got himself on the board with 3 there.
Boy, I tell you what, he loves getting looks like that from the three-point line. No one near him. That's a warm-up jumper for him.
Okay, Atlanta, let's get it going. For your very own Atlanta Hawks cheerleaders.
Check in for Horford. Ken Bazemore comes in for Worthy. Kyle Korver, he's checked in for Tim Hardaway Jr. And Dennis Schroeder subbed in for Teague. A new group in now for the Raptors. Biombo is checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Terrence Ross comes in for Damari Carroll. Powell, he's checked in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Joseph in for Kyle Lowry. Now, here's Joseph. Millsap at power forward with Horford at the center. Tim Hardaway Jr. out there with Dennis Schroeder. And it's Worthy in at the small forward spot. That's the group starting the second quarter for the Hawks. Raptors leading by five. Outside DeRozan. Here's the screen. Outside Lowry. Oh, and a fast break for Atlanta. Here's Schroeder. Score the basket. His second of two attempts. Toronto's gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. Lowry dishes to Joseph. Here's DeRozan. Misses, and the dry spell continues. The Hawks shooting pretty good tonight at 48%. At the top of the key, Millsap. Millsap a screen. Now here's Schroeder. Defense is right there. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. The Hawks have gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line. Damari Carroll checked in for Toronto.
Al Horford.
2 shots.
He's perfect from the line this time. Quarter number 2 with just over a minute gone. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. They set the pick. Back to Lowry. Six on the shot clock. Kicks it to DeRozan. I'm watching the line there. That'll be a backcourt violation. Atlanta with the ball. They're on a 16-6 run. Now here's Schroeder. Now recovering. And he misses the go-ahead basket.
He's always going to have a difficult time finishing when the defense is in his face like that.
DeRozan's shot is good.
Easy to see who's going to win that race.
Yeah, early offense is often easy offense. Excellent work that time.
There's the pass to Worthy. Wide open. And he gets the jumper to drop. Worthy's got 6 points. Raptors with the lead. Here's DeRozan. To the paint. Off the pick. Paul Millsap with the rebound.
Oh, he knows that one should have gone in. That hurts.
Schroeder kicks it over to Worthy. And for those of you just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. The 10-footer. Here's Millsap. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Really, the right play defensively, if you can't block, force him to the line.
Yeah, exactly. Prevent the layup, give him a little bump, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming into the lane next time. And if they don't think about it, at least they might be distracted by your presence.
Now here's DeRozan. Back to Lowry. Takes a big high bounce and goes in. Lowry's got his first 2 points of the night.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
Worthy against Carroll. The drive by Worthy.
Well, Kevin, a look here at last year in the NBA where the Raptors ranked. Second in steals. Second in opponent shooting percentage. And they also showed up in the top 5 in opponent's points per game. It's obvious the hard work this team has put into being good defensively has paid off.
And going back to the steals, they play a harassing style of defense. You have to be impressed with the effort they brought at that end of the floor.
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor and isolate up top. Spacing, fellas. Spacing.
We'll be right back.
very nice season for him last year. Put up about 16 points a game, 8 rebounds.
Ground and makes opponents work around him. That's good stuff.
For Toronto, they've gone 2 of 4 shooting the ball here in the second. Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Wizards really lit it up from the floor. He ended with 29 points, and he was just about on target from everywhere, hitting from deep as well as sinking his free throws. Just numbers that really jump out at you in a box score.
Great job, Doris. Thank you, guys. It's going to be very interesting to see if he can stay in a role like that tonight.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes those hot streaks can last for days, and I'm sure they'll be feeding him the basketball, hoping he's still got that mojo working.
Well, they ought to. I mean, when you've got a thoroughbred like him, I think you've got to ride him for as long as he'll carry you.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the knee and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you'd think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that.
Here's Biombo after the basket by Atlanta. 5 to shoot. Carroll passes to Valanciunas. Puts up the baby hook, and they force the shot clock violation. Great team. So it's Atlanta now. Their defense has only allowed 4 points in the quarter. Schroeder gets it over to Worthy. Outside for Millsap. And that misses. That would have put him up. And stolen by Worthy. They now take the lead. Worthy's got his 3rd basket of the night right there. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Hawks.
Well, I think the defensive aggressiveness on display here has caught them off guard, playing airtight defense and coming up with the steals.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Here's Schroeder and the rejection by Valanciunas. Now here is Lowry. 9 points last game out. The wide open look here for DeRozan. And the Raptors hit again from deep.
Kyle Lowry with a beautiful setup.
I don't want us taking shots with hands in our faces. Move the ball. Move the ball. Spread their defense and get our shooters some clean looks. Tighten up.
A different look here. Mike Scott's checked in. And we've reached halftime in this one. The Raptors out in front, up 10. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, obviously a lot of ground for you guys to make up in that second half. Do you expect Coach to shake things up to try to jumpstart you here in the third?
Yo, you better. I'm about to pop a blood vessel up in there. Stand losing like this. Yo, if he needs any suggestions on what we can change, he can come to me. Because I've been keeping a list all half. About 5 pages long at this point.
Wow. Kevin, not sure what to do with that one.
Thank you, Doris. And folks, don't go away after the break. We'll see you right back here for the start of the second half in the third quarter.
Okay, everybody, pay attention. We definitely got some stuff to go over from the first half. We're not going to let this game get away from us. The first thing is that we've done nice work immediately attacking whenever they force a turnover. That approach has to stay the same in half number two because the points are never going to come any simpler than that. I will point out that all the steals we got in that half as something we can build on. We pestered them with our D. That was great. Okay, in terms of pace, let's keep things moderate next half. Turning this game into a track meet might hurt us more than it will help us. I do not want to see a repeat of those first two quarters. Let's play like the team we are, not the team we were in the first half. I don't know who that was, but it's not us.
The second half just about to get going here. You look at Patrick Patterson, he's really playing well.
Yeah, you know, one of the things about the truly greats of our game is that sometimes you get spoiled because of how consistent they can be. And so far, another big scoring night for him.
And oftentimes when he puts up that many points in the first half, he follows it up with an even better second half. We'll see if that's the case here.
And on the floor for Dwayne Casey starting the second half, the star pair of Lowry and DeRozan are the guards. Patterson is the four with Valanciunas in the middle. And it's Carroll in at the three, the small four. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Worthy with the double team. Back to DeRozan. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. DeRozan's got the lead up to 10 now for the Raptors. T kicks to Horford. Passes it to Worthy. Horford with a screen on Carroll. Worthy against Carroll. Worthy dishes to T. Clock at four. The fader misses off the left iron.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's